Members of the Adult Stem Cell Research Initiative at the University of Notre Dame are investigating groundbreaking new ways to cure human diseases. Stem cells have the unique ability to become any type of cell in the body, giving them great potential for medical therapies. Because of the ethical implications associated with using embryonic stem cells, researchers at Notre Dame are looking at the potential of adult stem cells. Professors David Hyde and Rebecca Wingert utilize the zebrafish model to study human disease. The zebrafish has the distinctive ability to regenerate dead optical receptors using stem cells. Professor Hyde hopes to shed light on these mechanisms, with the ultimate goal of finding treatments for blindness and potentially other degenerative diseases.
A variety of different diseases, degenerative diseases in particular, currently do not have any sort of ability to be treated in a normal medical fashion. So, such as if you have a severe heart attack and heart tissue dies. Stem cell therapy provides a way in which, theoretically, we can regenerate that dead portion of the heart. And there's a variety of other diseases that occur in which cell death occurs that stem cell therapy might be a good therapy for, such as different forms of blindness, Parkinson's disease, Alzheimer's disease. All of these different diseases are due to the death of particular types of cells that we hope we can regenerate through the use of adult stem cells.
The Initiative on Adult Stem Cell Research and Ethics at the University of Notre Dame brings together researchers from every discipline to discuss the various issues that are associated with adult stem cells, from science and engineering to law and philosophy.
Notre Dame has positioned itself as the premier Catholic research institute within this country. And people are going to look to us for guidance on these sorts of issues and questions. And so our ethicists and lawyers can speak to the ethical issues and the legal issues associated with using human embryonic stem cells versus adult stem cells. But without the scientific underpinning, those arguments become somewhat hollow. And so what we want to do at the university is to also build up the science and the engineering aspects of using adult stem cells so that we're making cutting-edge progress. We're making the initiatives which are showing that adult stem cell research is a formidable approach in medicine. Adult stem cell research and therapy is one initial aspect of medicine that's going to blow wide open in the coming decades. And so we hope to be able to educate scientists, lawyers, ethicists, theologians at the undergraduate level in the breadth of this sort of context so that as they move up in their profession, they have that broad training, that broad education, and that then they can make informed decisions and help to get those informed decisions out to the general public.
Another wonderful example of how support from the Notre Dame family has enabled significant progress for adult stem cell research is a recent gift from Michael and Elizabeth Gallagher, which supports three new endowed professorships for the study of adult stem cells, including the work of Professor Wingert.
I think Notre Dame is poised to make unique contributions to the field of stem cell biology because our mission is to improve the lives of people around the globe. And one of the promises of stem cell biology is that this could allow for innovative new ways to treat diseases, both to detect disease and treat it in ways that are currently unknown.
So at the University of Notre Dame, we have a vision for creating an adult stem cell research center, which we want to be able to allow the creation of an organization which draws in the faculty from across the entire university. But now we want to bring the whole thing up to the next level. And I think by having a group of young faculty coming in, it will really invigorate and build up that research program and allow us to take that next huge step forward, which will gain major prominence for the university and for stem cell researchers.